Heteroscedasticity, Wikipedia Audio. In statistics, a collection of random variables is heteroscedastic from ancient Greek hetero different and skedasis dispersion if there are subpopulations that have different variabilities from others. Here variability could be quantified by the variance or any other measure of statistical dispersion. Thus heteroscedasticity is the absence of homoscedasticity. The existence of heteroscedasticity is a major concern in the application of regression analysis, including the analysis of variance, as it can invalidate statistical tests of significance that assume that the modeling errors are uncorrelated and uniform, hence that their variances do not vary with the effects being modeled. For instance, while the ordinary least squares estimator is still unbiased in the presence of heteroscedasticity, it is inefficient because the true variance and covariance are underestimated. Similarly, in testing for differences between subpopulations using a location test, some standard tests assume that variances within groups are equal. Because heteroscedasticity concerns expectations of the second moment of the errors, its presence is referred to as misspecification of the second order. Definition. Suppose there is a sequence of random variables, y, t, t, equals, 1, n, / brace, and a sequence of vectors of random variables, x, t, t, equals, 1, n, / brace. In dealing with conditional expectations of yt given xt, the sequence t equals 1 n is said to be heteroscedastic if the conditional variance of yt given xt changes with t. Some authors refer to this as conditional heteroscedasticity to emphasize the fact that it is the sequence of conditional variances that changes and not the unconditional variance. In fact, it is possible to observe conditional heteroscedasticity even when dealing with a sequence of unconditional homoscedastic random variables, however, the opposite does not hold. If the variance changes only because of changes in value of x and not because of a dependence on the index t, the changing variance might be described using a stochastic function. When using some statistical techniques, such as ordinary least squares, a number of assumptions are typically made. One of these is that the error term has a constant variance. This might not be true even if the error term is assumed to be drawn from identical distributions. View logarithmized data. Non-logarithmized series that are growing exponentially often appear to have increasing variability as the series rises over time. The variability in percentage terms may, however, be rather stable, use a different specification for the model, apply a weighted least squares estimation method, in which OLS is applied to transformed or weighted values of X and Y. The weights vary over observations, usually depending on the changing error variances. In one variation, the weights are directly related to the magnitude of the dependent variable, and this corresponds to least squares percentage regression, heteroscedasticity consistent standard errors, while still biased, improve upon OLS estimates. HCSE is a consistent estimator of standard errors in regression models with heteroscedasticity. This method corrects for heteroscedasticity without altering the values of the coefficients. This method may be superior to regular OLS because if heteroscedasticity is present, it corrects for it. However, if the data is homoscedastic, the standard errors are equivalent to conventional standard errors estimated by OLS. Several modifications of the White method of computing heteroscedasticity consistent standard errors have been proposed as corrections with superior finite sample properties, use Minkai or even the customary estimators, S I 2 equals N I 1 1 J Y I J Y I 2 equals backslash sum, whose efficiency losses are not substantial when the number of observations per sample is large, N I 5 5, especially for small number of independent samples. For example, the error term could vary or increase with each observation, something that is often the case with cross-sectional or time series measurements. Heteroscedasticity is often studied as part of econometrics, which frequently deals with data exhibiting it. While the influential 1980 paper by Halbert White used the term heteroscedasticity rather than heteroscedasticity, the latter spelling has been employed more frequently in later works. The econometrician Robert Engel won the 2003 Nobel Memorial Prize for Economics for his studies on regression analysis in the presence of heteroscedasticity, which led to his formulation of the autoregressive conditional heteroscedasticity modeling technique. One of the assumptions of the classical linear regression model is that there is no heteroscedasticity. Breaking this assumption means that the Gauss-Markov theorem does not apply, meaning that Ohl's estimators are not the best linear unbiased estimators and their variance is not the lowest of all other unbiased estimators. Heteroscedasticity does not cause ordinary least squares coefficient estimates to be biased, although it can cause ordinary least squares estimates of the variance of the coefficients to be biased, possibly above or below the true or population variance. Thus, regression analysis using heteroscedastic data will still provide an unbiased estimate for the relationship between the predictor variable and the outcome, but standard errors and therefore inferences obtained from data analysis are suspect. Biased standard errors lead to biased inference, so results of hypothesis tests are possibly wrong. For example, if Ohl's is performed on a heteroscedastic data set, yielding biased standard error estimation, a researcher might fail to reject a null hypothesis at a given significance level, when that null hypothesis was actually uncharacteristic of the actual population. Under certain assumptions, the Ohl's estimator has a normal asymptotic distribution when properly normalized and centered. This result is used to justify using a normal distribution, or a chi-square distribution, when conducting a hypothesis test. This holds even under heteroscedasticity. More precisely, the Ohl's estimator in the presence of heteroscedasticity is asymptotically normal, when properly normalized and centered, with a variance-covariance matrix that differs from the case of homoscedasticity. In 1980, White proposed a consistent estimator for the variance-covariance matrix of the asymptotic distribution of the Ohl's estimator. This validates the use of hypothesis testing using Ohl's estimators and White's variance-covariance estimator under heteroscedasticity. Heteroscedasticity is also a major practical issue encountered in ANOVA problems. The F-test can still be used in some circumstances. A classic example of heteroscedasticity is that of income versus expenditure on meals. As one's income increases, the variability of food consumption will increase. A poorer person will spend a rather constant amount by always eating inexpensive food. A wealthier person may occasionally buy inexpensive food and at other times eat expensive meals. Those with higher incomes display a greater variability of food consumption. Imagine you are watching a rocket take off nearby and measuring the distance it has traveled once each second. In the first couple of seconds, your measurements may be accurate to the nearest centimeter, say. However, 5 minutes later, as the rocket recedes into space, the accuracy of your measurements may only be good to 100 m, because of the increased distance, atmospheric distortion, and a variety of other factors. The data you collect would exhibit heteroscedasticity. However, it has been said that students in econometrics should not overreact to heteroscedasticity. One author wrote, "Unequal error variance is worth correcting only when the problem is severe." In addition, another word of caution was in the form, "Heteroscedasticity has never been a reason to throw out an otherwise good model." With the advent of heteroscedasticity, consistent standard errors allowing for inference without specifying the conditional second moment of error term, testing conditional homoscedasticity is not as important as in the past. For any nonlinear model, however, heteroscedasticity has more severe consequences. The maximum likelihood estimates of the parameters will be biased, as well as inconsistent. Yet, in the context of binary choice models, heteroscedasticity will only result in a positive scaling effect on the asymptotic mean of the misspecified MLE. As a result, the predictions which are based on the misspecified MLE will remain correct. In addition, the misspecified Probit and Logit MLE will be asymptotically normally distributed, which allows performing the usual significance tests. However, regarding the general hypothesis testing, as pointed out by Green, simply computing a robust covariance matrix for an otherwise inconsistent estimator does not give it redemption. Consequently, the virtue of a robust covariance matrix in this setting is unclear. Astiriou, Dimitros, Hall, Stephen G. Applied Econometrics. Palgrave Macmillan. Pages 109-147. ISBN 978-0-232718-2-1. Davidson, Russell, McKinnon, James G. Estimation and Inference in Econometrics. New York, Oxford University Press. Pages 547-582. ISBN 0-19-506011-3, Doherty, Christopher. Introduction to Econometrics. New York, Oxford University Press. Pages 282-99. ISBN 978-0-19-956708-9, Gujarati, Damodar N., Porter, Don C. Basic Econometrics. New York, McGraw-Hill Irwin. Pages 365-411. ISBN 978-0-07-337577-9, K. Menta, January. Elements of Econometrics. New York, Macmillan. Pages 269-298. ISBN 0-02-365070-2, Madala, G.S. Lahiri, Kajal. Introduction to Econometrics. New York, Wiley. Pages 211-238. ISBN 978-0-470-01512-4. Consequences. There are several methods to test for the presence of heteroscedasticity. Although tests for heteroscedasticity between groups can formally be considered as a special case of testing within regression models, some tests have structures specific to this case. These tests consist of a test statistic, a hypothesis that is going to be tested, an alternative hypothesis, and a statement about the distribution of statistic under the null hypothesis. many introductory statistics and econometrics books, for pedagogical reasons, present these tests under the assumption that the data set in hand comes from a normal distribution. A great misconception is the thought that this assumption is necessary. Most of the methods of detecting heteroscedasticity outlined above can be modified for use even when the data do not come from a normal distribution. In many cases, this assumption can be relaxed, yielding a test procedure based on the same or similar test statistics but with the distribution under the null hypothesis evaluated by alternative routes, for example, by using asymptotic distributions which can be obtained from asymptotic theory, or by using resampling. There are four common corrections for heteroscedasticity. They are: heteroscedasticity often occurs when there is a large difference among the sizes of the observations. The study of heteroscedasticity has been generalized to the multivariate case, which deals with the covariances of vector observations instead of the variance of scalar observations. One version of this is to use covariance matrices as the multivariate measure of dispersion. Several authors have considered tests in this context, for both regression and grouped data situations. Bartlett's test for heteroscedasticity between grouped data, used most commonly in the univariate case, has also been extended for the multivariate case, but a tractable solution only exists for two groups. Approximations exist for more than two groups, and they are both called Box's M-test. Most statistics textbooks will include at least some material on heteroscedasticity. Some examples are: detection, fixes, examples, multivariate case, notes.